everybody. We're out here at the NHRA looking for cool cars. And you know, it's not that hard, but every once in a while, there's one that's just over the top. Check this out. Lynsi Snyder's beautiful Chevrolet Chevelle making its debut right here. Lynsi, this thing is incredible. Tell me about your ride.
Well, it's a 69 Chevelle and running in top Sportsman. This engine, 709, it was a Chevy Hemi that used to be in my Cuda, 70 Cuda, that we now have in a Chevy. So, you know, it fits here. But it's the same heart of the top Sportsman that I've been racing. It's pretty sick if you look at it. The design I did with a tattoo artist, and the painter, Jeff, did an amazing job.
So. Yeah, tattoo artist, right? Like the skull. Hopefully everybody can get in there and see. There's a lot going on inside there that maybe you don't notice at first glance.
Yes, the details are incredible. So we really worked on it, went back and forth. And one thing that's different is, you know, each side of the car is a little bit different. Just the way that he did the paint, the ghost flame, or not the flames, but the ghost flames and the design, the leaves, everything through it is just amazing. And I think people pick up different details each time they look at it.
Now, the car is also, like, the paint is a work of art, but it is a work of art by Jerry Bickle. Now, we've seen your Cuda in the past, and that's a great machine, but this is, like, brand new. You've talked about how long you waited for it, the reality of taking delivery of this thing and being able to strap in there and get in and race it. What was that like?
I've been waiting, and I'm so, so thrilled, so happy with what Jerry Bickle's shop did. It's just incredible. It's a work of art. So from the outside to the inside, the whole thing is a quality machine, and I'm just absolutely love driving it, and couldn't have come back to racing with a better car.
What was your best ET in speed?
670 at 206.
Oh, getting after it. What did the Cuda used to run?
I think I did a 673 in Sonoma one time with perfect conditions, but the top speed was 202.
All right, so you're right at your best already with this machine. It's going to be great. Can we see under the hood?
Yeah, absolutely.
All right, let's pop the cap off, guys, and it'll be after the fact, but I can reveal, like, this thing's getting an award here at the race.
Yes, I'm so excited, and I think rightfully so, because it is just beautiful.
It really is. And we are about to expose the engine. You're very proud of this. But my goodness, just over the top. Here we go, the Flying Dutchman.
Yeah, that's so my dad's nickname was the Flying Dutchman. And when he used to race, it was Flying Dutchman Racing. So honoring him, I race under Flying Dutchman Racing. And, you know, that's the ship on the other side, on, you know, our crew shirts and gear. And then, you know, the anchor and the heart is on the anchor. And that's actually ties to one of the tattoos that I have about your faith being the anchor to your soul and everything. And then, you know, the skull for me, I just kind of love them. But, you know, life is short. And so.
Well, you know that better than anyone, someone who came up. And you've been, it's been kind of interesting listening to you, a bit of a spiritual experience. Coming to the drag strip, people don't make that connection, but that is the case.
Yes, absolutely. And I think whether people, you know, face that or not, it is very real. And, you know, for me, God is the most important thing in my life. And, you know, and while I'm in that car, that relationship is, of course, you know, there's special times because it's kind of me and God, and of course the connection to my dad and racing and stuff. So
can we see you in the cockpit of your race car?
Yeah, love to.
All right, Lynsi Snyder, and of course the heart and the anchor and just so much going on here. You could study this paint job for a long time and not see every detail. First week in a new car, you know, what happened out there in competition?
Oh, I went red. Yeah.
It happens. It happens, right? It happens to the best of them. Half the field get cut in half. All right, tell us what we got going on here. Oh, look, you got a Max Pappas steering wheel. She's got all the great stuff. Walk us through your procedure, what you do when you make a run.
Okay. Well, of course, I get all safe and snug in here with my belts and the Hans device. And then, you know, movement becomes very limited. and then I'm reaching to try to get my helmet and, of course, my ear protection. And and all of that. And then, you know, it really, I just kind of go through checklists. I'm also a helicopter pilot, so, you know, checklists and just kind of mentally walking through things before you do it is just part of my instincts, whether I'm driving or flying. And so, yeah, I just kind of go through what I'm going to do in my head, and whether it's just a time run or, you know, first round, of course, or whatever round, I'll start walking through the plan, you know. But, of course, you know, I've got all these fun switches in here, and making sure that all the right things are on and everything's in the right order, and just figuring out for this season actually which hand I want the trans button on, because I'm left-handed but I'm ambidextrous, and so I'm like, it's a new season, maybe I'm gonna move it to the other side. So that is one thing I'm trying to
where are we leaning on that. People don't realize that's a big decision right there.
It is, yeah. I do a lot of things right dominant even though I'm left-handed, so I'm kind of thinking I'm gonna move it, but luckily.
That's what most people do, by the way. Most people are right-handed with the button. But all right, so normally the big finish on Attention in the Pits is we fire the car. We cannot fire the car because she's getting ready to go up for the big award ceremony for winning Best Appearing. But I don't think we've revealed the amazing car and the amazing character, but we have yet to reveal the big tie-in with In-N-Out Burger and the In-N-Out Burger Pomona Dragstrip tie, the In-N-Out Burger Finals. You, your dad, your multi-generational drag racing family connected to In-N-Out Burger, a passion for so many people on the west coast of the country, and this weekend the big debut. Just speak on that for a second.
Yeah, I mean, it's just really special. I think the heart and soul behind the connection, you know, muscle cars, classic cars, drag racing has been a part of In-N-Out's culture since the beginning, and with Harry having the involvement and a part ownership of the original Irwindale, you know, and actually serving pretty much In-N-Out burgers unbranded, you know, at that track, and then being out here and having the In-N-Out Burger Pomona drag strip and serving our burgers here, it's just beautiful. It's wonderful, and it's really exciting, and I think my family would be so, so happy and thrilled. And you know, I always think through things and say, well, what would my family think? Should I do this? Should I do that? And this one I just feel would have a big, big kiss from heaven.
Amazing. And I just am so appreciative of the whole thing and the fact that we're going to be here for the finals, but really most of all, I can now get a double-double at the track. Lynsi, thank you for sharing your car with us.
Oh, thank you. Thank you for having me.
And that is why you come out into the pits here at the NHRA.